To be completely honest, there's just something peaceful about swimming. I've always loved team sports, but the instant I got into swimming, there was just something that stuck with me and kept me there. I won't lie, that this has been the hardest training I've ever done. Rather complicated, because you have to balance strength with endurance. So it's usually swim in the mornings, early in the mornings, and then take a break, do some work, and gym in the evenings to get the strength up. Diet is also rather complicated. You can't give the same diet to two different swimmers in two different events. But I try to keep it clean, stay away from sugary things. Anything unhealthy, I've really sort of thrown off my plate for a while. Well, Uganda has come a long way, I'll admit, but I feel like we still have a ways to go in terms of swimming. Some of these countries have had the sport for over 100 years. I'd say the longest we've had it is about 20 maybe. So while we have vast talent, I feel like there's still a small way to go, but I think we're getting there slowly by slowly. Completely honest, this is my first time. Even the greats like Michael Phelps, when he won his 8 medals, it was his 3rd Olympics. So trying to keep it realistic, do my best and see where I can go from there. Most swimmers peak at around 21, 22. I still have a while to go. And I have to keep that sort of thought in mind, plan for the future and not just in the moment. Success would be doing a great time for now. Where I am at this stage, I want to go in and create a time that makes it easier for me to go to follow-up competitions. Failure would be getting disqualified, of course, or not showing up to the race. But I'm being realistic and I'm going to go get the experience and see where I can head from there. Of course, everyone admires Michael Phelps. But in terms of sprinting, which is sort of my thing, I really admire Nathan Adrian. He's an American, he's massive, but he's extremely talented, and I think this will be his 3rd Olympics as well, so I'm watching out to see what happens with him. I think my greatest achievement is making it to Rio. I wasn't sure that they'd accept the time, but so that would be a big one for me. My greatest failure, I think, would be there was a period where I was on and off swimming and I still had to swim a rather large meet, and so the time I made in that meet was kind of, as compared to what I was expected to make, it was not what I expected. Yes, I've seen Eric the Eel.
Well, I thought I'd seen everything in the Olympic swimming pool. We've had 9 world records, we've had 19 Olympic records, and I've just seen somebody go 1 minute 52.72 for 100 freestyle.
He bit off more than he could chew. That's the truth. Like I said, you have to be realistic. If you train for 1 year, don't go for an event that Michael Phelps, who's trained 4 years to do, goes for. You have to be realistic and hopeful as well. It's okay to be ambitious, but you have to realize what kind of training you've done and what that training is for.